Dear fellow scholars, this is 2-Minute Papers with Dr. Károly Zsolnai Fehér. Today, we are going to create beautiful virtual clothes and marvel at how quickly we can simulate them. And the kicker is that these simulations are able to create details that are so tiny, they are smaller than a millimeter. And when I first saw the title of this paper, I had two thoughts. First, I asked, sub-millimeter level, is this really necessary? Well, here is a dress rendered at the level of millimeters. And here is what it would look like with this new simulation technique. So many crisp details suddenly appeared. Okay, you got me. I am now converted. So, let's proceed to the second issue. Here, I also said, I will believe this kind of quality in a simulation when I see it. So, how does this work? Well, we can give it a piece of coarse input geometry, and this new technique synthesizes and simulates additional wrinkles on it. For instance, here we can add these vertical shearing patterns to it. And not only that, but we can still have collision detection, so it can interact with other objects, and suddenly, the whole piece looks beautifully lifelike. And, as you see here, the direction of these patterns can be chosen by us, and it gets better because it can handle other kinds of patterns too. I am a light transport researcher by trade, and I am very pleased by how beautifully these specular highlights are playing with the light. So good. Now, let's see it in practice. On the left, you see the coarse geometry input, and on the right, you see the magical new clothes this new method can create from them. And yes, this is it. Finally, I always wondered why virtual characters with simulated clothes always looked a little flat for many years now. These are the details that were missing. Just look at the difference this makes. Loving it. But how does this stack up against previous methods? Well, here is a previous technique from last year. And here is the new one. Okay, how do we know which one is really better? Well, we do it in terms of mathematics, and when looking at the relative errors from a reference simulation, the new one is more accurate. Great. But hold on to your papers, because here comes the best part. Whoa! It is not only more accurate, but it is blistering fast. Easily 8 times faster than the previous method. So, where does this put us in terms of total execution time? At approximately 1 second per frame, often even less. What? 1 second per image for a crisp, sub-millimeter level cloth simulation that is also quite accurate? Wow! The pace of progress in computer graphics research is absolutely amazing. And just imagine what we will be able to do 2 more papers down the line. This might run in real time easily. Now, drawbacks. Well, not really a drawback, but there are cases where the sub-millimeter level simulation results materialize in a bit more crisp creases, but not much more. I really had to go to hunt for differences in this one. If you have spotted stark differences between the two here, please let me know in the comments. And here comes one more amazing thing. This paper was written by Huamin Wang, and that's it. A single author paper that has been accepted to the SIGGRAPH conference, which is perhaps the most prestigious conference in computer graphics. That is a rare sight indeed. You see, sometimes even a single researcher can make all the difference. Huge congratulations! This episode has been supported by Lambda GPU Cloud. If you're looking for inexpensive cloud GPUs for AI, check out Lambda GPU Cloud. They've recently launched Quadro RTX 6000, RTX 8000, and V100 instances, and hold on to your papers because Lambda GPU Cloud can cost less than half of AWS and Azure. Plus, they are the only cloud service with 48GB RTX 8000. Join researchers at organizations like Apple, MIT, and Caltech in using Lambda Cloud instances, workstations, or servers. Make sure to go to lambdalabs.com/papers to sign up for one of their amazing GPU instances today. Our thanks to Lambda for their long-standing support and for helping us make better videos for you. Thanks for watching and for your generous support, and I'll see you next time.